Welcome back after lunch. I hope you all had a good lunch. So the session now will be Professor Vashne. I invite Professor Vashne from IIT Kharagpur. He'll be talking about NMEICT activities in IIT Kharagpur. Professor Vashne.
So good afternoon to all of you. And on behalf of NMEICT team at IIT Kharagpur, I heartily welcome all of you to that. For the next 30 minutes, what we are going to discuss, our progress, the journey so far at IIT Kharagpur, right, in training T10KT program. And Professor Rajadatta, actually, who is the PI of the this program at IIT Kharagpur, he is currently out of India for some academic conference. And Professor P.K. Biswas was in morning, so he will be joining very shortly. And myself, I'm here. And Mr. Subrato Naik is in the technical on the team, is here. Right, so we started just to tell you about the, I think, objective. You already know about this one. So to conduct some kind of like a, to conduct a technical teacher's workshop. So aim is to mainly the training the manpower and to make it the advanced courses. And to especially we have been having looking in the task one to the greatest participation from the northern eastern part of India. Right, so we'll show you some kind of like a set that we have over the last few. So the we started up NMEICT office in 2013 with the instrumental, the person was late Professor Somna Sen Gupta, actually who somehow actually it's like during the course on to the signals and systems, I think he was got sick, very sick, and then and we couldn't, I think he left us. So that was he started, so he was an instrumental person in having a setting of the NMEICT office at IIT Kharagpur. And then we in March, the first we started with the workshop on analog electronics, where we had the 221 remote centers, and in the main workshop we could reach, we had a 7,427 participants. And subsequently in September 2013, that was from the electronics again, we had a, again the course was from the electronics again, it was signals and systems, where 236 were the remote centers, and there we had the participant around 8,730 figures, that's the participant. And in 2014 March, we had a course in fluid mechanics by Professor Suman Chakravarti and other two eminent professors. So where he had the remote centers were 229, and the main workshop we had a 7,451. So then we moved to the electrical engineering domain, where we had a successful course on control system, where we had a 239 remote centers, and within a, I think this was the highest figure that we had around 8,886 in control system. And then in 2015 March again, we had a course which was mainly design of algorithms, which was taken by our director, honorable director, Professor Partho Pratim Chakravarti itself. And there we had a remote centers around 229, and the participants were around 7,000. So the later on, we moved into the civil engineering domain, where we had a course on the structural engineering, and where the number of participants were around roughly 4,000, there's a 3,800. And latest, the recently one, we have finished the course on the CMOS mixed signal and RF VLSA design, where we had participants of around 4,633. So that was till the February, as Professor Pathak has mentioned, that because of the octave of the financial support, so there was some delay. Of course, now we are coming up with a workshop. The workshop is on electric power system, again from the electrical engineering. We had also thought from the manufacturing technology, but due to the non-ability of the teachers during this time, we couldn't make it. That's be kept in mind for the probably later on. So that's the course, which is an electric power system. So where the main, the coordinated workshop would be held in from the 1st May to the 5th May, 2017. And then the main workshop would be the blended model. It would be in from July 10, that's till the July 14. And we have the three different, you can see the spectrum we have in the faculties, one from IIT Kharagpur, one from IIST Calcutta, and one from IIT Bombay. So three different from three different institutes we have right now, the faculties who would be giving a course on the electric power system. To just give you a feeling, what are the things that we have planned is look into the start from the components of the power systems and renewable energy resources, basic tools of analysis, and then power system analysis software, control of power systems, application of ICTs, smart grid system protection, and asset management. Right, so these are some of the course modules. The details are already onto the web, I think, is nmeict.iitkgp.arnet.in. You can have a look into the details. And to give you the few of the stats that we have gathered for over the all the courses that has been conducted. So in on average, we right now, I think we have touched more than 50,000 numbers of participants that we have trained till now. That's more than 50,000 teachers have been trained from IIT Kharagpur side on these courses. So if you look into the ratio, the gender ratio, so I think we had quite nice participation from the women's side. That's from the female, we had more than 40% of the participation from the female, and the 60% is male. So I think it's quite good a number. And if you look into the qualification part, so what you see that most of the percentage that the people who attended this all these courses are mostly we have the master's level, right? So with the highest figure of around roughly 73%. If you look into the age group of the participants, so what you see that the between 25 to 30 is the most of the participant. The age group was we had the more around 40% of the overall the participant. That age group of the participant were roughly between 25 to 30. So if we look into the overall rating for all the courses, so I think we had done very well with the 44.5% says been excellent courses, and 42% is very good, and the good is 13%, and not so good 0.6, and 0.6 number, so is 0.12 is poor. So I think we have done fairly very very good in terms of these workshops. Right, if you look into the contents, so what's the people have given the feedback, if you look into that one, the very good is more than 65% is very good on to the workshop contents, and then good is about 25%. Right, so what we have taken the initiative in Eastern region, so we had started inducting the few new remote centers that has been inducted this time. So that was in the Jharkhand BIT Mesra. In West Bengal region, you have the five these centers, Siliguri Institute, J.S. Kalani, CEM Kolaghat, Bankura, and then you have Supreme Knowledge Foundation, Hooghly. In Orissa, we had College of Engineering, Bhuvaneshwar, CEB, NIT, Rourkela. In northern eastern part, we had the NIT Manipur, NIT Meghalaya as our the remote centers. Right, so if you look into the stat, so what's the plan ahead? Because Professor Pathak has mentioned that we have to move further for the some kind of like a self-sustained mode. So we are going to have some kind of discussion. We had discussion with the director, and then we are working on to the methodologies. How can we make it self-sustained? For example, you can have utilization of these facilities, what we have at the IIT Kharagpur on the some kind of floating some at the weekend ICT based workshops. Or the student workshops, so to generate kind of like some can think of generating revenues, and how does this impact kind of assessment analysis part. So these are the few things that we look into the downward next to the line. And if you look into the northern eastern report stat, we see that around 30% of there are the female participant from the northern eastern part, and roughly 73% we have from the female participants. And if we look into the age group, so roughly 34% is between 25 to 30. Again, that group which mostly take, let's say participants are, we are from this age group. And if you look at the qualification, again, is the same as an MTech level, even if you look at northern eastern part, if you look into the overall, what you have presented just before. So if you look into this still, is a the highest gainer is the people who had the basic, like say, degrees, the MTech. Right, so that has been the so far. So if you have some questions, so I'm is open for the questions or discussions. Thank you very much for kind attention.
Sir, different areas are covered as in your workshops. I would just to highlight that so far, the engineering mathematics, I think that is not concentrated. For example, application of Fourier series or Laplace transformation.
Yeah,
we
have thought for some kind of like algebra course that can be useful. Basic, that will be better, I think. Yeah.
Okay, definitely. Sir. Thank you.
I make a note for that one. I note it down.
Modeling.
Yeah, mathematical modeling of the general systems or something like that.
For all.
Yeah, basic. Mathematical foundation that you like to, okay.
That is foundation like use of differential equations and other type of models we can form.
Yeah, that I'm saying. The PD, start from the PD towards the advanced level, right?
Look, being a mathematician, I will request to you, sir. Yeah. Operational research, it plays a very pivotal role in applied sciences.
Operations and statistical?
Yeah, something. Exactly.
I just note it down and then we'll discuss it back at home and then definitely. It's in the electrical power system, it is this time.
Excuse me, sir.
Please.
In your forthcoming workshop,
yeah,
in electric power system, will it be possible to add a high voltage engineering area, maybe few lectures? High voltage engineering.
High voltage engineering.
Yes.
Yeah, actually that we'll discuss definitely with the faculties there. And if it can be included, I think it's not in a problem. Right, so we send an email that these are the topics that you, whatever the modules we have, this is a kind of like maybe definitely modification can be done. Yeah. But just put up an email. Just send an email. This is the topic that we like to high voltage engineering. Right?
Yes.
Something like that.
Okay.
Few lectures on this.
Sir, excuse me, sir. So in the last meeting, that is 29th November 2014, it was decided most of the workshop will be conducted in the month of December and June.
Yeah.
Now again, you are conducting this workshop in July. From our...
That's the main workshop you mean to say? The main workshop in July, right? Something.
Yes, yes. That is in July.
Yeah, true.
So it was decided the workshop will be in the month of December and June only. Because in our site, in month of July, we are having the classes and peak periods.
Yeah. So I make a note of this one. That I think the issue probably might be because of the availability of the faculties. May not be available during that time. So that's probably the dates have come up after the due discussion with the faculties.
Sir, 1%. I have a suggestion over here for the previous workshop which has been conducted by IIT Mumbai. That was based on research methodologies. In that, we have found that every field, any faculty belonging to all the fields, they participate generously. So I want that if IIT Kharagpur will conduct the similar type of workshop which can benefit the overall community of teachers.
Okay, we are more general kind of like
research method.
Not very, very focused, but kind of research.
Yeah, because research the need of the...
I think about already IIT Bombay has doing is.
But
we
can
to have from
if some added flavors can be added to that.
Some flavors, different flavors and different.
Yeah, that's true.
So in the course on power systems, what lab activities are you proposing?
Okay, for this, I don't have the answer at the moment for you.
Because you have mentioned PSCAD and here.
Application of ICT. So actually. Probably, I'm not very suitable person to talk on the electrical power system, so probably I can discuss back to with the concerned faculty, Professor Kishore at IIT Kharagpur, and then I can reply to you. You can send an email for that one. Yes,
okay.
What are the lab component you like to include into Zoom? You want to have a lab visit? Something like that? You want to have
No. Suppose you are mentioning PSCAD, then the remote center should have that software. So that's why I'm asking.
True. Yeah.
Hello, sir. My request is you have said that power system course is included. Any possibility of power electronics and drives course, sir?
Power electronics?
Yes, sir.
Sir?
No, this is mostly related to power systems.
Okay. You want them power electronics?
Power electronics and drives.
And drives. I'm noting down your suggestion, so probably I won't be giving any. Confirm answer to you at the moment, but definitely we'll discuss.
Sir, here.
Please.
Let me first thank Kharagpur for providing excellent courses in excellent way. And all our participants are very much happy with the way in which it is being conducted, as well as they are getting the certificates, as well as the funding is released so quick properly. Even now we have received the funding and certificates for the recent workshop which has happened. Thank you so much. And I request you to conduct a few more workshops on computer science and IT related topics. And let it be advanced topics which are there.
Computer science like this.
And IT related advanced topics.
Security or something like
that. Not basics. We want to hear the best from IIT.
Okay. Advanced in advanced level, right?
Yes, sir.
Artificial intelligence, something like that?
No. More? Latest trend.
Computer architecture.
No. Okay. Thank you.
Sir, can I talk?
Sir.
Excuse me,
sir. This way.
Yeah, please, sir.
Similar thing I would like to continue what my colleague, remote center coordinator, was saying, that courses from cloud computing or from wireless communication or embedded systems, these should also be taken up in near future from IIT Kharagpur.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Is it possible to arrange one course on Internet of Things? So that is the huge requirement today in industry.
Yeah, definitely.
And it is an interdisciplinary course.
Yeah, we have the expert faculty, definitely we can look into
it. You have a very good setup there.
Yeah. Embedded system and image processing, you can merge together. Hello, probably that's will be better.
Sir.
Yeah, hello, sir.
Yeah, please.
Sir, I understand T10KT is basically for training teachers, yeah. But the assets of the institution is also the technical and non-teaching staff. If you can focus on few of the workshop orienting towards our technical staff, maybe the best practices followed in IITs could be in Kharagpur or Bombay would strengthen
you want
the department.
Hands-on, something like that? Technical, like training, like kind of hands-on experience of the technical staff, or just only?
Either way around, the best practices what you follow in the IITs could be embedded in our institutions too.
I'm noting down. Thank you for the suggestion. It's nice. Please.
Sir, in the beginning, as you have mentioned that you were interested to conduct on manufacturing science. In future, you have any plans to conduct on that?
Actually, this we had these two options. So because of non-availability of the faculties during this summer, so we have launched to the electric power system. Probably manufacturing technology might be the next.
Next, means Dr. Patak has mentioned in the morning that you are going to conduct two FDPs. Next will be on manufacturing science?
Yeah, that's we are targeting.
Yeah,
that's we say actually because of the non-availability of the faculties, we couldn't finalize manufacturing technology. But so then we had the electric power system. So probably the next would be your manufacturing technology.
Right, sir. Thank you, sir.
I'm just giving you that, but not assurance, but I'm just giving you the words. Right.
Excuse me, sir. So,
I have a topic over here, as my friend mentioned, regarding the computer science and IT. There is the future computing that's called pervasive computing. If you can arrange one workshop on that.
Advanced, I just noted down advanced level under the computer.
Pervasive computer.
Okay.
Pervasive computing.
Yeah, high computing as well. Yeah.
Good afternoon, sir.
The need of research in image processing area demands that we should have a workshop on soft computing techniques, because now it is moving rather from computer vision, it is going to civil engineering and electrical engineering also.
Yeah.
So few techniques of classifications in depth, and specifically with practical analysis and practical approach, because once the students study the theory, they will understand, but the application part is difficult. So they cannot apply it on, say, suppose Scilab or MATLAB. If we give them a particular problem, then they will be finding it difficult.
Thank you. So, I noted down. Soft computing, sir, I have noted down.
But sir, in that course, we require more lab hours as compared to theory.
You can just put your suggestion in an email. Okay, this is a, that, like to see some of the contents into your this course. Just put up an email.
Sure, sir.
Sir, from mechanical side, IIT Kharagpur has already conducted for related to fluid mechanics.
Yeah.
I would like to suggest for the related to design, if you can arrange a workshop.
Actually, what we are next is from mechanical, the manufacturing technology we thought actually. So design I am not, but I am just noting it down.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Sir, kindly include some lab sessions for all the subjects, whichever subjects you are taking for FDP or HGB.
Lab session may be possible when, like, on coordinator workshop, that might be possibility, but not for the probably the main workshop. But those who people who go there, probably they can have the probably can do some of the hands-on experience. That's the thing. But how you can do it in the main workshop in virtual mode?
Because we have a virtual labs and all facilities
have,
with us.
Yeah, we have some of the virtual labs, and if you look into the virtual lab, we have, do have. But I'm not sure about the, in every course you can have, actually.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Sir, have you finalized the content for manufacturing technology?
For the?
Content for manufacturing technology, not at... Okay, right. Thank
we
you.
Actually we discussed with the experts actually, and then we, because they were not available during this summer, so we didn't move further. Then we finalized electric power system.
Means can we suggest?
Yeah, you can definitely most welcome. You just send an email.
Hello?
To NMEICT, that email ID.
Yes.
Definitely, please.
So we have observed that the faculty members of IIT Bombay conduct courses from IIT Bombay, and faculty members from IIT Kharagpur conduct courses from IIT Kharagpur. Sir, is it possible for you to call faculty members from other IITs to conduct courses from your centers?
Probably, I think that's the answer to your question. We are the three different, from the three different institutes.
Yeah, okay.
IIT Bombay, IIST, Calcutta, and then IIT Kharagpur itself.
Yeah, that is
it's
very
possible.
Nice.
So that's the, I think that's a answer for your right now query.
Hello. Actually, yeah. I am person from Kurukshetra University. So, do you have some curriculum on VLSI design tools or nano simulation tools?
Yeah, we have. I think we those who attended VLSI definitely must have seen it. Tool design tool is there, but it is not freely available. I mean, it is not open source.
Okay.
Yeah.
Then there are some
software, commercial softwares are there, do make it.
So if we would like to organize such workshop.
Yeah.
So are you not planning to organize such, means because we need the advanced type course basically. Mm. So we do have M.Tech in nanoscience, M.Tech in VLSI technology,
yeah,
in our department.
Yeah.
Okay, we do want means some courses on means advanced VLSI tools like Cadence, Synopsys, and nano simulation tools like,
yeah,
virtual.
Actually, theoretical knowledge definitely can help you, but unless the software is there at the at your desktop, at the computer, you cannot go together, right? So definitely the person who can give the course, let's say sitting, let's say I suppose I can definitely describe, but it won't help unless you do practice, right? Definitely we can have look into the that part, but I'm,
yeah,
what the software uses onto the like Cadence or those things, definitely.
Okay, and workshop on nanotechnology, etc.
Yeah, we can think of nanotechnology, definitely. I noted down.
We should emphasize on advanced techniques, basically.
Yeah, okay. Definitely.
It would be good.
Sir?
Yeah. Yeah, from where?
Here.
Yeah, please.
Yeah. Regarding the promotion of this any FDP program to the nearby colleges, are you providing any materials actually, or some funds for promoting to nearby college? Actually, that is not demarcated for that purpose. Promotion of this FDP goes to the nearby colleges.
I got your point, but I'm not the right person to really give the answer on the financial part.
Some pamphlets, some posters, so that we can...
That's possible.
Yeah.
That's possible. But regarding giving us some kind of support, financial support, I am not the right person to give...
Not the major amount, small. Materials as well as the
Any kind of a very small amount also, I am not the right person to give you the any answer on that.
Okay.
So any more suggestion you have or any other questions? I got very broad spectrum from the manufacturing to the IoT, so I think it's fine. Anything else? From nano to macro, actually, I should say.
Sir, there was one suggestion for conduction of such workshops for support staff, technical support staff.
I have written.
So I just want to reinforce that suggestion.
Okay, I have written that one. So any other question here? It's fine. You can send an email, it's fine. Whatever the your suggestion or the content you'd like to have, definitely you can write an email and we'll revert back. Thank you.